Now, speaking of crazy ideas, we wanted to get Ian's take on what will happen this year by fast-forwarding all the way to June. School's out, class is over, and the awards are given in our NBA yearbook. Wow. What an animation. Let's begin with best dressed.
I'm the last one to comment on fashion. I have no fashion
sense. Oh, come on.
No, it's been about 10 years since I've worn something that's in vogue. But even I know that Russell Westbrook is the best dressed guy in the NBA. I mean, the Rockets put a red carpet in their arena for him and Harden to have a little fashion show pregame. That tells you all you need to know
about.
Yeah,
it's very interesting
what he's
game day ops idea, but I love that. Yeah, he always has something funny. He had something, I believe, last night, probably wild as well. Let's get into something also fun. Class clown. Who do you expect this to be?
Joel Embiid. I mean, I love what he does on social media, especially after games, like when he has a big game against, like, let's say, an Andre Drummond or a Hassan Whiteside. He always takes funny shots at them, and he says he's not going to do it this year. He's done trash talking. There's no way. He loves it.
Especially on Twitter, too.
He loves it.
Tweets at LeBron James forever, just like trying to get him to come to Philly. It was
and Rihanna.
No, we need guys like him in the league. Okay, who do you think is going to be headed for Hollywood? And this, we mean this in the movies.
Right, so Kyrie Irving, he starred in a film already, The Uncle Drew.
Right.
Pick. I mean, say what you want
what
about
hit.
The quality of the acting, but I feel like it probably made enough money where they'll do something else and they'll do another, you know, remake for Uncle Drew and he'll get a cast of characters. Maybe Kevin Durant will be in the movie this time, but I think he, while he's not the best actor in the league, he's most likely to get another.
Who do you think's the best actor in the league? Throwing you.
I don't think anyone's very good.
No one's really.
I'm not a cinephile, but I don't think
LeBron is a good actor, though.
Is he?
Yeah. Trainwreck? He was great in that.
He was good in Trainwreck. Yeah. He made me laugh in Trainwreck. Yeah. Amari, who's not in the NBA, Amari Stoudemire, was good in Trainwreck.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and we got to hear Space Jam 2 will be, or 3, whatever one it's on now.
Two.
Okay. Two. I thought I missed one. I didn't. Okay, next. most talkative.
Patrick Beverley. Mm-hmm. I mean, you just saw the other day with what he had to say to Steph Curry about how the next 5 years are mine. And Steph had a funny retort. He said, aren't you 31? According to a report. But he always has something to say on the court. He's a fantastic defender. It leaves people to not pay attention to what he doesn't give them on offense, which I think is smart by him. But he's such a good talker, and he makes the league more entertaining.
Yeah, he's always barking out there. Okay. Now, let's see who is most likely to lose an NBA Finals.
The Milwaukee Bucks. They're on that trajectory to where they've advanced in the playoffs. They've kept a lot of continuity together for the most part. I love the coaching staff there. Giannis Antetokounmpo, obviously, I think they all take the next step together as a group to get through the East, and then they lose to whatever juggernaut comes out of the West.
How come? Why do you think that they're going to be the ones?
You know, I think that what they've done this offseason, I know they lost some key guys, but they kept the core mostly intact. And again, I just love Mike Budenholzer. Mm-hmm. And the way he coaches that team, the way he has prioritized three-point shooting for the group around Giannis Antetokounmpo. I think, again, he takes the next step forward. I think his outside shooting improves, and just the experience that they've had and he's had in the playoffs, he knows what it takes now. And I know they've worked really hard as a group over the summer to get going this season.
Yeah, tough to be beaten by a Canadian team. Couple of nobodies last year. Who do they lose to, though?
Oh, that's a great question. I'm going to go with the Clippers. Yeah, mm-hmm. I think the depth is there, the star power is there. As long as they can keep Kawhi healthy, as long as Paul George comes back healthy, I think they're the team to beat in the West.
Ooh, that's exciting. Man, Kawhi getting another ring.
You would love that.
Yeah, I'm okay. I got one, so it's all right. I whatever. We're not real journalists on this program. Last one, most likely to win a Grammy.
I'm going to go Damian Lillard. Again, I'm not the fashion. Same thing with music. I listen to children's music now. I have two young kids.
Oh, you do? Okay, what are you into?
I haven't heard any. I'm not into any of it, but I do sing along with the kids. So I say that to say I haven't heard any new music in a couple of years, but I've heard that Lillard is skilled, is a skilled lyricist, so I think he'll continue along that path, and he's better than Shaq, I've heard. I heard they did a little battle this summer, and he won the battle, so I'm going
Damian. Shumpert's also a rapper, too, but...
But he's not in the league right now.
Not good.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's not in the league also.
And not good.
And not good.
Wow.
And not good.
Killing you.
All right. This has been real great. Yearbook.